If you're watching this video, you already know all the amazing things that glutathione does for you. From skin benefits to immune system, better night's sleep, just like this is a master antioxidant. I feel like it's been pounded into everyone's head how amazing glutathione is and how much you need it more. You just need more of it in your stores, more of it in your life. But what people don't talk about are the other side effects of glutathione supplementation, which pros honestly might overweigh why you're even taking it in the first place. Starting off, I just recently learned that glutathione helps your hair stay in the anagen phase. Now, when I was on it for about 8 months consistently, that was the longest I've ever been on it each day, and I had the best results, but I noticed that my hair grew a lot, and I thought this was because I was wearing protective styles. Little did I know that it's also a mixture of my hair being in anagen stage. Basically, what glutathione does is that it keeps your hair in the growth phase longer. For some people, if you've ever noticed, okay, why do some people grow the longest hair and then others, it's like it peaks around 18 to 16 inches. It's because that's genetic. How long your hair naturally stays in the anagen phase, the growth phase, is totally genetic. So it ranges anywhere from 2 to 8 years, which that is huge. So you can imagine if it can stay in the growth phase from 2 to 8 years, then that means for some people, it is out of that growth phase from 2 to 8 years. So this could be a problem for a lot of people. And this is all like clinically backed. Like this isn't just like an opinion. They have actually proved this. So taking glutathione, it's not only going to help you shed less hair, but it's going to help it be in the growth phase longer. Now, of course, if you're bleaching the crap out of your hair, if you're frying it with hot tools, I mean, there's only so much you can do. So take it with a grain of salt. How you're also treating your hair is going to basically show how long your hair is going to get, how strong it's going to get. I talk about hair health a lot on my Patreon because we talk about just like everything related to glowing up in your skin. And there are definitely some products that are actually worth the money and that will help you grow out your hair longer. Another thing that I noticed is that vitamin D and glutathione kind of go hand in hand. There's been studies that show that when vitamin D was down, glutathione's down. When glutathione is up, vitamin D is up, and that by supplementing glutathione, it actually makes like vitamin D more bioavailable. For me, I take vitamin D3 and K2. The K2 also helps the vitamin D be more bioavailable, but I've noticed, because I've taken vitamin D for years, but I've noticed when I'm just taking regular vitamin D, it's like I get the benefits, but if I'm taking it with K2, it's like my focus is better. Like everything is better. I feel like even like libido, which if you guys didn't know, vitamin D3, it is a hormone and it does, you know, all of those good things when you guys are having your special time. Your vitamin D levels also play a part in that as well, which getting further into the hormone things, glutathione also helps you to detoxify hormones. So for those of you who may make too much like estrogen, or if you have dirty estrogen, which dirty is just, it's when estrogen basically, when it is, how could I put this? It basically, when it goes through your liver, somehow it gets circulated back into your bloodstream and it isn't truly purified. So what glutathione does is that it purifies this estrogen. So you're not having those mood swings, unwanted hair in places that you should not have it. It could be facial hair, it could be back hair. And it also helps you with just like regulating your appetite, your cravings for sweet and stuff like that. So it's very, very, very important. Not only that, like, so it not only detoxifies your hormones, but it also helps in making progesterone, estrogen, and testosterone, which we all, women, we need all three of those. And we make all three of those at varying levels at different times of the month. So I did not know that glutathione also helps with hormone support, but there you go. So for you girlies who have crazy periods, or for you girls who have mood swings, this could also help. Another thing I feel like people don't really talk about is that being on such a high dose of glutathione, like, so this isn't for the people who are just taking like 500 milligrams to 2000 a day, but when you are mega dosing glutathione, taking a lot of it, I notice that I do have a change in my appetite. I don't snack as much. And I need to look into this further because I'm finding some articles on glutathione and weight loss. So it's like, okay, that could be a thing, but also I'm mega dosing vitamin C. And I know that that also controls like ghrelin, which is like a hormone that's given off when you're hungry. So for some people, it's like you make more of ghrelin, and for others, it's like you have a healthy amount. So it's like those two, mega dosing vitamin C and mega dosing glutathione, you know, both could be contributing to why I'm not snacking as much and why, I mean, I'm eating a normal amount. I wouldn't say I'm eating less. I'm just eating like a normal amount. I'm not overeating because sometimes I am an emotional eater. Like, I'm bored. Let's eat. But I don't feel like anyone's talking about it. And I don't know if it's because the majority of the world is not mega dosing glutathione, or I don't know. Tell me if I'm the only one. Another thing I noticed that, well, I didn't notice, but I researched that it does, is I wanted to understand how glutathione and melanin work. And basically, when you're making melanin and you have like huge glutathione stores, so you've been on glutathione for at least 90 days, you're taking it daily, you're being consistent, for those people, you will not, basically it blocks melanin from synthesizing. And so if you go outside, obviously you can still tan. Any melanin cells that are already in your skin, like, you cannot stop that pigment from darkening. Glutathione does not work in that way, which when I first found out about glutathione back in 2019, that's what I thought I was getting into. I thought I was finding like an internal sunblock. No. And yes, yes, I found it, but not in the way I wanted. I wanted it to not allow me to get darker. It cannot do that. You will still have immediate pigment darkening. And usually it's using the melanin pigment or the melanin cells that you already have produced. What it can do is inhibit new melanin pigment synthesis. So that means it's making less the more glutathione you have in your blood system. And this totally goes back to how long you've been on glutathione, and if you've been consistent with it. Are you taking it every day? Are you taking things like ibuprofen, which is almost as bad as like drinking a ton of alcohol? Binge drinking alcohol and taking ibuprofen, it can zap any glutathione that you have. When drinking alcohol, I think it is safe if you're just having like a glass of something light. So that would be like a champagne or a white wine, something like that. It's just like when you're getting drunk enough, when you're drinking enough to get drunk, that really it kind of depletes your stores. But I just thought that was really, really interesting because I wanted it to work in that way. I was like, I didn't want to get darker while being on glutathione, and it doesn't work in that way, but it does work in the way that it inhibits new melanin pigment, but any melanin you already have in your cells, you're going to see that darkening. Also, and I learned this recently, there is delayed pigment darkening. So this is something that happens almost overnight after sun exposure, to where you're waking up the new day looking darker. Glutathione is known to help stop that. And that's something that can happen. I mean, well, does happen to people after you've had like a day at the beach. For some people, it's like the tan is baking. Thankfully for us on this channel, we know how to get around those temporary tans, but I just thought that was pretty interesting. If you guys are interested in my day-to-day glutathione and supplement routine, I'm posting that video on Patreon, and we're basically checking in there every single day, all throughout the day. We are on our 30-day glow up, and oh my gosh, things are changing and a lot of really exciting things are happening over there. So definitely go check that out. So excited. My 90-day accelerated skin lightening checklist planner is now ready. This is perfect if you're struggling to keep up your routine or if you don't know where to start. Basically, this is like day by day what I did to achieve my goals within 3 months. I tell you basically everything you need to know. All you have to do is like check off the box. So I should tell you like what to take in the morning, what to take in the evening. For different weeks, you guys will be doing like coffee enemas. There are certain times where you'll be doing just different exfoliation routines. I show you or tell you about what topical I mix together. It's really affordable. This isn't like something you're gonna have to like put hundreds of dollars into, but it'll get you started. And basically these are my results doing this exact routine from basically like 3 months, like 90 days. So if you guys are interested, there is a link in the description where you can get it. I'm just so excited for this. Like I worked so hard on it, and yeah, it tells you just step by step what to do every day. You just check it off. You don't have to really think about it. And yeah, it's going to really help you achieve your goals.